introduction. Honorable General Edward Browning, Honorable Senator Minister Anna Maria Anders, I would say General Anders after his speech today. Thank you. Chairman, leaders of Polish society in the United States. First of all, I have to say that this is really a great honor for me to be here and the first time in this place. To be here with you, with leaders of Polish, of Polonia, we call it, of Polish societies, Polish diaspora in the States. So I'm very grateful to you that for this possibility to be here with you. And I would like also to send regards and greetings from Polish government and personally from Prime Minister Beata Szydło to all of you and to the Polish diaspora in the United States. My topic refers to the culture, to the national heritage, and to the possible ways how to change Polish image through cultural tools. I start with some general remarks. The transition in Poland after 1989, as you know, has been a period of constructing a democratic country in all areas of public life. Although we all are aware that this process of changes is very difficult and it takes time to change a country after communist time into democratic model. New priorities and challenges naturally appeared. Polish cultural diplomacy in the service of a democratic state is, or at least should be, aimed at supporting realization of Polish foreign policy strategic objectives by promoting its culture in the world. The development and global strengthening of the Polska brand. Polska brand is something which we're trying to push forward. So the development and global strengthening of the Polska brand through culture is currently the most significant strategic objective of Polish culture diplomacy. It is a far-reaching and long-term objective, which requires many years of coordinated promotion of programs abroad and consistent internal activities to support the development of culture and cultural institutions, with special focus on creative industries currently experiencing a dynamic growth in Poland. The evolution of the strategy employed by Polish cultural diplomacy for the promotion of a positive image of Poland in the context of a long-term strategy for developing the brand of Poland in the world shows that our rich culture, artistic activity, talented people, monuments, as well history and historic anniversaries are real assets which should be used for promotional purposes. Cultural heritage encompasses a broad spectrum of resources inherited from the past in all forms and aspects, tangible, intangible, and digital, including monument sites, landscape skills, practices, knowledge, and expressions of human creativity, as well as collections conserved and managed by public and private bodies, such as museums, libraries, and archives. Taking advantage of these resources is an effective way of raising public awareness, disseminating information about good practices and promoting research and innovation as well as policy debate. Part of the text which I probably missed somewhere. No, it's okay. Additionally, the image of Poland is a precious capital supporting fulfillment of our political and economic ambitions, as well as contributing toward the marketing success of Polish products, the flow of foreign capital and development of tourism. Culture, along with economy, should become an element successfully building the image of Poland as a modern country respecting the tradition, creatively looking to the future. Through culture, foreign individuals could better understand our country, build their trust and positive association. Culture is now one of the most recognizable elements of the brand of Poland. Changes in the perception of contemporary culture, whose products are more and more frequently treated as market and tourist products, require designing adequate and coherent strategies for culture promotion. In this context, culture emerges as a significant factor in Poland's social and economic development, as it has an impact on shaping its image in the world. The success of promoting Polish culture abroad depends not only on the quality of a given cultural phenomenon, but also, and perhaps primarily, on its good reception and on effectively reaching the foreign public. Therefore, it is essential to involve local specialists, people of culture and culture managers, who are able to evaluate the attractiveness of Polish proposals. They are familiar with the local artistic and organizational reality, which translates into the final shape of the Polish program. Their engagement brings hope for building long-term institutions and artistic connections. Contemporary Polish culture and art provide the crucial instrument in the process of creating a long-standing positive narrative about today's Poland, and which should entail strong and modern nation branding relying upon culture. However, taking into consideration that most rankings on the recognizability of Poland as a brand abroad still place it far behind many other countries, it is clear that the creation of the Polska brand is a difficult and complex mission. I can even add that there have been made a lot of mistakes in this politics. And the result is that the Polish image is rather low in any statistics. In many parts of the world, Poland is still not associated with anything specific, and its reputation and image abroad is much worse than it deserved after 27 years of transformation. I could present a lot of statistics concerning different indexes measuring this position. But let's say that, generally speaking, the position of Poland in all these indexes are very low and there is no real change in the situation. I mean, we are still under our expectations, that's for sure. So, summarizing this part of my intervention, the question is, why, despite broad cultural potentials, assets, resources, artists, national heritage, all these positive processes we know, all these events, heroic achievements, Poland does not exist as a positive brand in the world. One possible answer refers to the definition of the very term cultural diplomacy. The definition of cultural diplomacy was formulated in 2003 by Milton Cummings, and according to this definition, cultural diplomacy is the exchange of ideas, information, arts, and other aspects of culture among nations and their peoples, in order to foster mutual understanding, which, on the other side, can also be more of a one-way street than two-way exchange. As when one nation concentrates its efforts on promoting the national language, explaining its politics, policies and points of view, or telling its story to the rest of the world. This is one of the most frequently quoted definitions, especially the first part, in academic works analyzing the links and relations between cultural and public diplomacy and nation branding, as well as in publications analyzing the importance of culture as a soft power asset in international relations. However, the aforementioned definition refers clearly to double task, or to two goals of cultural diplomacy. One is mutual understanding, exchange of ideas, cooperation, and so on. The second is one-way street, promotion of countries' own interests.